Diamonds are forever. Falls on open and caresses. Welcome to the AFC RDA TV. I'm here at Lowestoft after another dramatic win for the Diamonds, 3-2, and I'm here with Monday Match Connor Furlan. Connor, we made hard work of it in the end, didn't we?
But we did.
Got over the line.
I thought, you hit the nail on the head there. We made hard work, but I don't think they challenged us too much. I think we weren't at the races for the first half. We nicked a win and a goal at the beginning. Like I said, we made hard work. We should have been all over that.
We'll talk about the first half. I don't think we had a shot on goal until about the 40th minute.
Oh, yeah, exactly.
He bounced right for you and you just hit it.
Yeah, they were trying to call it offside, but as a goal scorer, I'm trying to go until I've been told otherwise. So I'm always going to finish it. I thought I was onside. Well, obviously, I wasn't.
We'll take it. But then, end of second, that first half, we had another couple of chances. And he seemed to get the boys going.
Yeah, definitely. There's a vibe. There's a little vibe going. Massive vibe going at the minute. It seems like we just can't lose any. You're seeing we're 2-1 down. It's so easy. Like the gaffer said in the change room, it's so easy for teams to just die down at 2-1 down. You know, after going 1-0 up and seeing two goals, it's easy to just lose your composure and just crumble. But just us, I don't know. We just fought back. I was never in doubt that we were going to lose that game. And it just showed at the end, you know what I mean? How many last 10-minute goals we scored? So, and Nathan with a fucking outstanding goal.
And we believe you had a second goal, by the way, direct from the corner.
Oh, yeah, I've watched it with my own eyes from the corner. It's definitely gone over the line, but it's one of those you can't, unless the refs give it, it's not a goal. But yeah, I've seen it cross the line. It definitely should have been the second goal.
And as you say, it did change the game. They got back in it. They've got exactly. A really good striker, Reid.
Yeah.
He scores lots of goals.
Yeah, he's quite
two good finishes. And as you say, that shows the team spirit. We came back into it. And I think our centre back did score quite a few goals.
Yeah, Hughes has come in and he's done his job, to be fair. He's composed in a box. He's dropped down to him. He's taking his chance, to be fair. Out of all the goal scorers, you know what I mean? he's taking it well. So,
and I saw him training on Thursday, the manager wants you to get behind and think you would get to the ball, wouldn't you?
Yeah. So he's come in and he's not changed much. He's like you said, he's drilled it into us. We've got where we are through how we've been playing. So he's not coming. He's not changed. He's not flipped it on his head. He's just putting little feeders in. He said, look, wide players, stay out wide. We'll have more joy. In the last two games, we've done that, and it seems to be paying off. So.
And so, first of all, you seem to enjoy your football, don't you?
Definitely, yeah. I'm enjoying it as much as I have been since I've been here this whole season. And hopefully, you know, we'll push for the playoffs and we'll get as far as we can. Hopefully, win it and carry on progressing and keep having fun with it. Keep smiling while I'm playing. Keep enjoying it with the boys, and you never know what happens.
And I suppose we knew Nathan. I think he got angry, didn't he?
Oh, yeah.
He saw the opportunity.
Nathan's got that in his locker. Like, he's one of them players, you don't want to get him angry because he'll just go and stick it in the top bins in the 90th minute, you know what I mean? So,
it's great 3 points and puts in a great opportunity to play today, so that cements our position at top five. We've got a break now, so a week on Tuesday we go to Peterborough Sports.
Yeah, we'll just go training Tuesdays and we'll just work hard, keep working hard in training and keep playing through these games, keep winning.
Thanks a lot, mate. Got
it. Thank
you, John and Connor. I'm now here with Diamonds manager Andy Woods. Andy, what a game. We were ahead, behind, 91st minute. Can you sum up your emotions after that one?
Yeah, I don't really know what to think, to be honest. Incredible character. I think 2-1 down, who knows? We've had a long journey up. It's a cold day. It's a team fighting for their lives. Said at half time the next 5-10 minutes was important. I thought we started the second half okay, and then a sloppy goal from our point of view to concede the equaliser. Didn't stop the first cross, didn't get close to the second one. The lads shanked it, so it's crept in and your back foot, and then they lifted, and then the second one they've gone 2-1. And listen, I've just said it's easy for clubs to go, teams to go, do you know what? Really fancy getting in, but not this lot. You know, they showed great character, kept the ball. We had loads and loads of set pieces, second half especially, but we kept asking questions of them. They defended them really well, you know, in fairness to them. The goalkeeper did really well for them. We felt we may have had one. The lads were saying they felt the one that went over the line, and their lads were saying it went over the line, but we didn't get it, so we kept going. Ryan's got the equaliser, and then, you know, the goal that won it was sensational. It looked like slow motion, but no, it was fantastic. Listen, everyone's always spoken about this team's character and personality, and again, it's been here in abundance today. That's a magnificent win.
Let's take it all the way back to the start then. You made one change to the side today with Hughes and Collard. What was the state of play with Alex?
Alex just wasn't available today, so Ryan, like for like, thought Ryan did fine. You know, I know he's not played for a while, so yeah, it was just Alex wasn't available, so Ryan came in, did well, obviously got his goal. So yeah, no major issues. It should be okay for the next game.
I thought it was quite a scrappy first half. Both teams just sort of battling for possession more than anything else. But the goal we scored, lovely ball from Nathan, and a great finish from Connor as well.
It was, yeah. We had one or two decent balls into the box. I still don't, you know. Again, we said at our time we could do better. We could certainly play better first half, but we got our noses in front. It was, you know, a long ball forward from Dean. Nathan kept it alive, and it was a really good finish, I think, actually, from Connor, one-on-one with the goalkeeper. And it, you know, we had another chance just before half time where you think that goes in, and it's probably a different second half. But yeah, you know, decent finish, got our noses in front, and we wanted to come out and start the second half bright and try and get the next goal.
You mentioned the half-time message. What was that?
It was to start the second half properly and on the front foot and not give them a foothold in the game, because if we came out second half and were sloppy and on the back foot, I thought we started the game sloppy. The first 20-25 minutes, we were slow in possession. I didn't think we moved it quick enough. I don't think we exploited the space down the sides. And I thought we started the second half okay, to be fair. We got down there, down in their half on the front foot. So yeah, the message was just to, you know, try and not give them something to hold on to, not give them some sort of hope. Unfortunately, it did transpire that way, and before we knew it, we were 2-1 down and chasing the game.
They obviously got the two goals in quite quick succession. I suppose when that happens, it's easy for momentum to shift, the crowd behind them as well. It would have been a big win for them and their survivor hopes, but like you said at the top of the interview, credit to the character of our boys to just stick at it, and then out of nothing really, scramble an equaliser.
Yeah, I mean, listen, I've been in lots and lots of change rooms where players look for excuses, and there was a great excuse for my players today. that they've gone 2-1 down away from home again in a dogfight, in a team in a dogfight, and the excuse could have been, do you know what, they didn't really fancy it, went totally the other way, stayed on it, got back into it, didn't put the heads down, didn't sulk or anything like that, got back into it with the goal from Ryan, and then won the game with a fantastic strike. So yeah, absolutely delighted with the players. Wonderful way to win a game of football and makes for a happy coach going home.
Let's talk about that winning goal. I mean, there's ways to win a football match, but there's not many ways better than to do it with a scorching free kick like Nathan did. And I suppose that there was a bit of venom and anger about that free kick, because things weren't going as well, decisions beforehand. I think the referee moved the actual ball before the free kick, but what a strike it was to win us the game, and he's earned that, hasn't he?
Yeah, I mean, Nathan didn't, by his own admission, I'm sure, didn't have the best game today, but big players, big moments, that was a big moment for us. There was sort of lots going on, there was little moments that the referee intervened and moved it back and things, and the anger, and you think of that Wayne Rooney volley, was it, at Newcastle, when he got angry with the referee and smashed it top corner. All that being said, the technique and the quality and the ability to do that is first class. Nathan, he was fantastic the other day. I thought he was our best player at home against Hennesford. As I say, he stepped up and won us a game with a magnificent free kick.
It's a big 3 points today. We move on to Peebles Sports in 10 days' time. I'm sure you'll be encouraging a better performance against a team who are, like us, flying high in the playoffs. That's a big game in the playoff race.
Yeah, very big. As I've said, when I came in, every game's a cup final. Every game's a scrap. It won't mean that there's any less effort or any more effort needs to go in than today. These were scrappy. This was at stages in terms of scoring goals, and it will be a test, but one that we'll look forward to. We've got 10 days to prepare now. We'll dust ourselves down from today. There's a few knocks in there, so it gives them time to recover, hopefully, and we're looking forward to the next game against Peterborough.
It's a long journey home. I'm sure after the way we won the game tonight, it's going to be an enjoyable.
I don't need love.